Once there was a beautiful girl. She dreamt of a happy life. A palace that was built on the banks of a river. A garden full of beautiful flowers and fruits. Sweet birds chirping all around. She waited the day when a handsome man would arrive and take her to a distant place of dreams. And one fine day, her Prince Charming arrived and took her to his palace, and then they both happily lived ever after. Cute bedtime story, isn't it? Almost every girl has seen this dream for herself. Life looks so like a beautiful gift in this story. But is reality the same for every other girl? Today, we'll be seeing the story of a princess who dreamt of a better life but went through hell, and how this iron lady managed to carve a heaven out of hell. Kalpana Saroj, born in 1958 in a small village of Maharashtra. Her family belonged to a lower caste community and lived on a meager income on a daily basis. Poverty could only allow her to study till class 7th. Post that, she was pushed into a forced marriage. She came to Mumbai with her husband and started living in a slum area with a family of almost 12 people in a small hutment. She was forced to physical and mental torture from day one of marriage, did all the household work and lived like a slave. Her father cried at her condition and took her back to village. Back home, things were even worse. She started studying again, but this was not looked good in the eyes of the villagers. Troubled by this ill treatment, she consumed poison but was saved by doctors. This incident brought Kalpana back to life. She wasn't that helpless girl anymore. She knew God had given her a second life, and this should not be wasted on self-pitying. She traveled back to Mumbai and learned the basics of tailoring work. She earned mere 2 rupees as daily wage. But not too soon, as things got settled, Kalpana's sister fell ill and died on bed as she failed to manage basic medicines of mere rupees 2000. That's where Kalpana realized the importance of creating wealth in life. In 1975, she turned to setting up a small cloth business with the help of a government loan scheme. The business took off well, and now she was busy setting up other income opportunities. By 1990s, she bought herself a land at 1 lakh rupees. The property was stuck in legal troubles. She overcame all the hurdles and partnered with a builder and developed the plot into an impressive property. This marked the turning point in Kalpana Saroj's career. In the year 1999, looking at her growing popularity, the workers of a dyeing company by name Kamani Tubes approached her to lead the process of re-establishing the company. Kalpana took up the challenge and got into a long and unending process of meeting government officials for loan waiver and restarting the operations. Finally, by the year 2010, her hard work paid, and as the chairman of Kamani Tubes, Kalpana Saroj transformed the company into a profit-making business group now valued to over rupees 2000 crores. Kalpana went on to become an emerging woman entrepreneur of the country with a personal net asset valued to over rupees 750 crores. Popularly known as the real Slumdog Millionaire, Kalpana Saroj was awarded the Rajiv Gandhi Award of Woman Entrepreneurship. Kalpana Saroj was also awarded the Padma Shri by the Government of India in 2013. Kalpana has held top key positions on the advisory boards of various leading educational and business bodies like the Bharatiya Mahila Bank, Board of Governors, IIM Bangalore, Honorable Indian Representative in the United Nations World Peace Committee. Nothing less than a Cinderella story, Kalpana Saroj remains one iron lady who went through immeasurable troubles of life but awakened the genius within her and conquered the world with massive hard work and a strong self-belief. Guys, let's draw inspiration from such towering personality and awaken the genius within us to scale new heights of success in our lives. Thank you.